Fabian de la Rosa was born on May 5, 1869 in Baco, Manila. It was a turbulent time in the Philippines, a country aching to break free from the throes of Spanish colonial rule. Fabian's parents, Marcos de la Rosa and Gorgonia Cueto, made sure that the young boy grew up immersed in culture and the arts. He was, after all, descended from a family of artists, including his uncle, Simon Flores y de la Rosa, a noted painter of religious icons, and his aunt, Mariana de la Rosa, who taught him to paint landscapes. Fabian was 22 years old when he painted La Perla de Lucban, his oldest known work. The year was 1891. 1893, Fabian would enroll at the Escuela Superior de Pintura, Escultura y Grabado, and receive his first formal art training under the tutelage of Don Agustin Saez. But it was not all art for Fabian. He was also a masterful fencer and took time to give lessons at the Sala de Armas, a fencing school established by the brothers Antonio and Juan Luna along Legarda Street in Manila. Meanwhile, a revolution was brewing in Manila, spurred by the writings of the country's foremost thinker, Jose Rizal. So in the year 1898, just as the second phase of the Philippine Revolution breaks out, that Fabian de la Rosa receives word of a scholarship grant to the Madrid Art Academy. Needless to say, the grim situation at his home country prevents him from leaving. The following year, 1899, a new colonial power emerges as the United States wrestles control over Manila. Fabian would be arrested and imprisoned for a day on accusations of participating in a plot against the Americans. He was released through the efforts of American consul Oscar Williams, who later commissions him to paint historical scenes. Among his works was a painting entitled The Death of General Lawton. In 1904, Fabian de la Rosa achieves worldwide acclaim by winning the gold medal at the St. Louis Exposition in Missouri, USA, for his painting entitled Planting Rice, making him only the fourth Filipino artist to gain international recognition after Flores, Juan Luna, and Felix Resurrection Hidalgo. A similar painting, also entitled Planting Rice and dated 1921, is now part of the Malacañang Palace collection. From 1908 to 1910, Fabian would further hone his craft through further studies in Europe as a scholar of Dr. Ariston Bautista Lim. By 1910, he was back in Manila, joining the faculty of the University of the Philippines School of Fine Arts as instructor in decorative arts. In 1926, Fabian de la Rosa would be named the first Filipino dean of the UP School of Fine Arts.
Fabian de la Rosa seriously engaged with the rural area. So, you know, what I mean by that is that he went out there, and because he's been influenced by the Impressionists in Europe, he started painting outdoors. And he's one great influence as in our research is that he was very taken by Gustave Courbet's paintings. He was greatly taken by the themes that Courbet painted, and these were the everyday folks, everyday people, the rural people who would toil the earth, so he valorized them.
His masterful portraits and sure portraiture of character, to his shimmering exterior landscapes, haunting interior scenes, and signature genre paintings. Fabian de la Rosa will finally be acknowledged as one of the greatest Filipino artists who ever lived.